You can now build and submit Expo apps to TestFlight using Replit. We partner with Replit to make mobile development and deployment feel effortless. Just prompt, generate your app idea, and when you're ready, hit deploy. Replit's mobile apps are powered by Expo Launch, meaning you are building a real React Native app with native output and shipping it without leaving the platform. Let me show you how it works. Create your app, just go to replit.com and then select mobile app here in this menu. And then you can say something like build a mobile app. Let's build a minimalistic to-do app, just as an example. Then press start and that's all. All right, and now we're cooking. And by the way, I also created a habit tracker application that it's actually already done. Let me show you how it looks once you're done. I made this application, by the way, just with one prompt, make a mobile Expo app habit tracker. And by the way, this is an Expo application. You can inspect the code, see everything here, change anything that you like. You can open the file inspector by pressing this icon or pressing Shift Command B. Super nice to be able to have shortcuts here. And if you go to the preview tab, you can just go to your iPhone and scan this QR code using Expo Go. So let's do that. Look at my app, guys. It's beautiful. We can say hello. And then we can even add a color, hit save. And by the way, it has some liquid glass, which looks really cool. So this means that it's a fully native application. But at the moment, this is living inside Expo Go. So it depends on the server to run. And I want to ship this to the App Store. So to do that, you can simply press on the publish or republish once you have published for the first time. And you'll see this start publishing to the App Store button. Now this uses Expo Launch under the hood, which means it's gonna be super easy to deploy. So let's press this button. You're gonna need an Apple developer account, of course, but this is going to launch Expo Launch within Replit. So we didn't have to leave the website. Then I can create a new project. This is going to be my habit tracker. Let's give it as log. We can press continue. Now let's sign in using my Apple developer account and press sign in. All right, now let's choose an application. Since this is the first time that I'm doing this, I'm going to create a new app. But if you are updating an existing application, let's say that you made changes, you can use an existing one. But let's just press create app. Okay, and everything is configured for me. I didn't have to do anything. Now I can press launch to the App Store. All right, and it's done. Now we need to wait between 10 to 15 minutes until Apple finishes reviewing and processing the application. All right, and after around 10 minutes, I got this email saying that my build has completed processing and my app is ready. So I clicked on the manage App Store settings. And this took me to my App Store Connect account. I'm in the TestFlight tab. And from here, you can create an internal testing group. So I'll call it internal. Hit enter. I'm going to add myself as tester. And just like that, I should be able to start testing my build. All right, and I just got the email. Let's press view in TestFlight. This is a standalone application, of course. You can install it directly. You don't need any server running or anything like that. This is just going to work. Let's open it and boom, we can still use it normally. And if I close it, this is how it looks. It's not in Expo Go anymore. It's fully deployed. From here, you can keep iterating using Replit or just go to the distribution tab under app information, change the name of your app, save it and submit it for review. You can start building and shipping today. I'm gonna leave the link in the description. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.